G'day everyone, it's Clayton from Planet Canada here. And today, let's go over some of the basics of cabinet modification. What changes can we make to our cabinets? And what are the cabinet settings at our disposal? Well, let's see. It's important to note that cabinets in Cabinet Vision are not necessarily static. The design isn't set in stone, which means that my object catalog to the left-hand side here is really essentially a list of cabinet designs I've saved to this catalog, to this library, so that I don't have to redraw them every single time I open up a new job. I can sort them and arrange them however I like, but essentially every time I grab this object, I can bring him onto the wall so that I don't have to redraw that same design. However, the wonderful thing about Cabinet Vision is that it can really grow with you as a user. It makes the process of drawing our projects, of optimizing them for the CNC, really as efficient as possible. If you find that during the projects you're working on in Cabinet Vision, you're doing the same task or the same repetitive adjustments for every single new project, well, the idea is we only make that adjustment once. We save that cabinet to our catalog, and then in the future, we can just grab that catalog or grab that object in the catalog and place it on our wall, and we don't have to redraw it again. The other important thing to note is any cabinet or any object that I take from this catalog, I can modify it to be any other design that I want to, so that I so choose. We can see that in action here. I've got my pair door in the center of the wall. If I double click on this cabinet, it's going to take me to the cabinet properties. And there's a few different areas of the cabinet properties that we're going to look at to see how we can make certain adjustments to our cabinets. But essentially, it's great that we're at the section view. The section view is where we're going to modify the face and interior of our cabinet. If I click on the section face, you'll see I can modify on the left-hand side different things like the type I'm using. You can have a pair door, slide door, a drawer. I can keep it open, have panels. And then the attributes underneath will adjust to the different type I'm using. I can also modify the face so that I have several equal openings all at the same time. So to do that, I'll remove the face as it is. I'll click on the horizontal multi-split. And now if I click on the section face, you'll see that I can choose however many equal openings I would like to add and what kind of opening type. So let's add 3 drawers. And just like that, I've now got a 3-drawer system, whereas as opposed I began with a 2-door base cabinet. If I remove, before I do get there, we can also click on the individual faces now and make adjustments that are specific to that object type. For instance, for the drawer face, I can change things like the height of the drawer face. I can change the positionment of the hinge, the depth of the drawer box, the clearances, and I can manually adjust the size of the face as well. If I remove the drawn face like so and click on the section interior, you'll see that I'm also able to manually add adjustable shelves, rollout trays, fixed shelves. To do that, I can do the same thing. I can use the horizontal multi-split, and that will give me the option to add equal openings and different separators. I can also right click on this space and split vertically or split horizontally. If I split horizontally, it'll give me the options for an adjustable shelf. I could also split vertically, and I would have the options for a partition or a divider. And then I could even now from this space split that horizontally and switch between my adjustable shelf, if I wanted a fixed shelf, a rollout tray, all those options are available to me. So that's the benefits of using the section face and section interior settings. You'll also see when we're in the section view, we have the properties button at the top here. When we click on that, we have basically a list of all of the properties that are attached to this specific cabinet. I could change its name. I can here change its size as well. You'll see from the different tabs, I could, for instance, change the construction method only on this cabinet. Maybe this cabinet has an exceptional construction method compared to the other cabinets in the same room or project. I can also change the colors, the materials that I'm using for this cabinet and just for this cabinet. The same for the door profile, the door material, the hardware we're using. But it's also important to note that I can use the case option to change or modify certain aspects of this cabinet, like whether or not I want there to be stretchers, a full top, a no top, if I want there to be no bottom on my cabinet. But it's important to note that when I'm making these adjustments, they're only for this cabinet. I don't want to go through and make these adjustments for every single cabinet, because these settings should already be established in our construction method. If I don't want a top on this cabinet, it should be because it's an exception to the rule. We can also add things like scribes, which are very important if we've got a job where the wall might run out and we want to have a little bit of room for installing the cabinet. We can also modify, for instance, the reveals. If I wanted to, I can change the height of the toe. I could remove the toe completely if I zero out all the options and turn off. You'll see that I've got no toe anymore. And the important aspect in using this properties feature is that the changes I make are intelligent, they're dynamic. When I modify the toe, you'll notice that Cabinet Vision also modified the ends so that they continue to the bottom. That's important to know, because if I now make adjustments here in my face, plan, or end view, I am able to click on a finished left end or a finished right end or my partition and manually change its settings. So for instance, with the partition, I could change the height of that partition myself, but you'll notice that the top and the ends haven't adjusted with that partition. That's because I've essentially told Cabinet Vision that I want to make a very specific adjustment just to this part and only this part. So it can be important for us as designers or engineers, if we are making modifications to our cabinets, that we're making the modifications in the right area. Generally, I would say focus on making the modifications in the section and the property tab, and only make the modifications and the face plan and end view for the really rare exceptions where it's necessary that a single part has to behave differently than normal. What I can also do is visit the section view and the modifications tab. And here is where I can make adjustments, like I can default my assembly to its original form, or I can remove very specific overrides. Here, I could just click on the override I want to remove, or all of them, click remove and okay, and Cabinet Vision will undo that change that I had made to the toe kit here. I can also now remove the partition that I have modified. So I can just click on it and click delete on my keyboard, or delete up here. And that will remove the partition completely. So now if we return to our cabinet and horizontal multi-split it so that we have maybe a five drawer system. If I was happy with this and I didn't want to have to draw a five drawer system every single time, I could right click on my cabinet now that I'm happy with its design. I can click on save. If I click on save as is, it will give me limited options or preferences for me to save, and it's going to override the object that I used initially, which we don't want to do here because I want to keep my base door pair. So instead, if I click on save as, it will now give me the option to find where in my catalog I would like to save this unit to. So let's go to the drawer system. I can change its name to be base 5 drawer. And if I also wanted to, I could preserve very specific information like the finish, the height, the depth, any attributes or adjustments I've made to it. I can also change the icon on the right hand side. And if I click on advanced, you'll see that I can toggle between different more advanced settings for this cabinet or object before I save it to my library. Once I'm happy with that, I can click OK. And now if I was to go to my objects and find where I had saved my cabinet, you can see that I've now got the base 5 drawer ready to go like that. And that just gives you an idea of some of the modifications we can make to our cabinets specifically.
Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this one, please be sure to like and subscribe. You can also check out our other videos that will help guide you on your path to becoming a Cabinet Vision Power user.